In front of you are the Aria Singers Class of 2018. Many years ago, the music teachers decided that we could never let our wonderful senior classes go off without a little token of our love and affection. And thank you to Mr. Scott Cannon for making the beautiful posters that you saw out back there. He does that every year, and I think the seniors really enjoy them, and the parents do. And they'll get them in a way yourself. So I'm going to name the seniors, and Mrs. Schumann, my fantastic, wonderful accompanist, is going to come here. Thank you. but it used to be the highest, right?
Yes.
First of all, if you can help me just a little bit to thank so many people. Every person sitting in this auditorium, I can't thank you enough from the bottom of my heart for the support you've given these students, last two students, the students the year before, and the year before, to have the tradition that has continued to excellence for the RA Singers. My principal, Beth Patton, the woman says yes to almost everything I ask her. And when I'm having a day that is just a little present, she always knows, and she'll just say, Christine, what's going on? And I say, and, you know, she has to problem solve together, which is one of my big things I say. Our director, Donna Watts, who has watched over our program for all these many years, she's been our director, fed my heart before her. My colleagues, Scott Cannon, David Klug, Sean Joseph, and of course, Mrs. Schuman. It's just been unbelievable to work with them, and just such a, you know, a bittersweet sadness to say goodbye to them. To all my parents who have worked so tirelessly for fundraising opportunities for the kids so that we can do all the things that we've done, how many times that we continued the European tradition, how many times we did new things, premiered oratorios, met with the Rochester Philharmonic Orchestra, sang in Carnegie Hall. Unbelievable, unbelievable memories and unbelievable things for some of you sitting here. I know some of you here tonight and things that you remember. It's like, oh, I went to France. Oh, we bought her that music stand up there. You know, just so many different things. I also just want to take it back a little bit. When I first started teaching, it was in Honey Falls, Iowa, and I was 21 years old, and was ready to take on the world, and I had a high school chorus and third part of the trade, which I loved. And then someone retired, and they said, you have to do 7-12 and 3-6, and I did 7-12, because I thought I'd enjoy that more long range. And then when I had my son's Joe Mike, it was a bit much to go between two buildings 5 times a day with my husband and a job that took him away traveling from time to time. So I went to a part-time job at Wheaton Chile, which I equally loved. There were some wonderful people there. And I worked part-time there until someone called me and said, you know, you live in Russia, you come to all the singers' concerts, and your kids go to Russia, Miata, and we think that you should have an RA Singer director job. And I said, well, you know, I've always been interested in it. And so I went through the process. And the last thing I said, what they said to me is, you know, if we hire you, our singers are a jewel in our crown. And you have to keep shining. Thank you. to know if some middle school girl is going to teach next year when I get to high school. And then I was really lucky enough to have my son Michael and our lead singer with me. Someone else auditioned him, and he sang one song tonight, the one that Tim Marshall had solo in, and I said Michael had that solo, so that was very near and dear to me to do that song again. And these guys are so indulgent. Now we have our dad band up here. Thank you to all of you. It's been such a great year.